where the he-goat waxed very great, became greater. He took over the territory. And when he was strong, the great horn was broken. And for it came up four notable horns toward the four winds of heaven. Now, here we go. Here we go. So you kind of are looking back in time, right? You have this ram with two horns from the east, who is being challenged by this goat with one large horn from the west. They clash, they fight. Then the goat wins, and out of the goat, the original kingdom is broken off. But when that kingdom was broken off, it was divided into four. So you probably want to be writing down, you know, this progression, right? So now there are four, and he goes on and he talks about it. And out of the one, then came four. Then came forth a little horn. So now there's the four, right? Remember, this is, should sound familiar to you. There's the four, and then out of there came forth a little horn, which waxed exceedingly great toward the south and toward the east and toward the pleasant land, the beautiful land, Israel. So, okay, there's four, and then this little horn. And the little horn is what we have all heard by now, you know, wherever you're watching or hearing or reading, you probably heard that the little horn is also representative of the Antichrist. So, clearly, we can see, where is the Antichrist coming from? I can hear you answering. Oh, yes, it's coming out of this Middle East, this whole territory. This, what was Alexander the Great? What was the Roman Empire? What was the Ottoman Empire? Coming out of this territory. Okay. Now, there are some who will say, because this scripture says that the little horn is seemingly coming out of this this territory, the Middle East in general, right? The Holy Land in general. That then says that the Antichrist cannot be associated with the Roman Catholic Church. Of course, I'm sure you've probably all heard that before, right? But I think I spoke to you last week to be reminded that who did the Roman Empire conspire with? And how did we get the name the Roman Catholic Church? Remember that the popes were heavily invested and involved with some of the emperors or pharaohs or whatever. I don't know. emperors of the Roman Empire. So while it's, you know, I don't want to say that the papacy or Rome or the Roman Catholic Church necessarily is the Antichrist, but remembering that there was that influence, right? And there have been a great many deaths, massacres that have occurred throughout the centuries at the hand of those who were sent by the Roman Catholic Church, i.e. the Templar people. I don't know why the names are escaping me right now, but there were crusades, right, and the Maccabees massacres and all those massacres that were at the hands of or at the encouragement of the Roman Catholic Church in cahoots with, right, in coordination with the early Roman Empire. So while there isn't maybe this, you know, direct path, but there certainly is some involvement, right? And so we see here, though, that he identifies, he being Daniel, in his vision, is saying that the little horn is coming up out of this territory that we just described, all the way from the west, Libya, Turkey, Egypt, all that, all the way over to the east, Persia, or Iran. And this little horn, the Antichrist, grows up and becomes exceedingly great. And And he is so strong and so great that he is taking over this whole area. And in verse 10, and he waxed great even to the host of heaven. And it cast down some of the hosts and the stars to the ground and stomped upon them. Now, I don't know if you all are hearing this, because maybe I need to read it again. And it waxed great even to the host of heaven. And it cast down some of the hosts and the stars to the ground and stamped upon them. He magnified himself even to the prince of the host. Who is the prince of the host? Who is the host of heaven? And by him, the daily sacrifice was taken away, and the place of his sanctuary was cast down. Are we, in fact, talking about Lucifer? Right? When Lucifer was cast out, and the third of the host went with him? Doesn't this sound reminiscent? I don't think there's a coincidence here. I think it's a direct relationship. So we see this. Because he magnified himself against the host, the heavenly host, the Almighty God, right? He wanted to exalt himself against God. Then he was cast down. And then who was the next one that he wanted to exalt himself against? The prince of the host. Who's the prince of the host? Jesus the Christ, the Messiah. So we can see right away there's already this fighting, right? There's already this enmity, as the word says, between Satan and the heavenly host, certainly, between Satan and God the Father, God the Son, and of course, he's against the Holy Spirit as well. And then we are reminded in Genesis, when the curse was given to Satan, that you would always have enmity, argument, conflict between the woman and her seed. And the woman, remember, is always thought of, or ultimately thought of, as the church, the body of Christ, the children of Israel. And this same fight has been going on for centuries. Because God said this is what would happen. And he determined, what was this? Part of the curse. That there would always be this conflict between the church, the woman, and the Antichrist, Satan, Lucifer, the devil, the beast, the false prophet. Amen? I hope that you're able to see that now, maybe more clearly. And he goes on to say in verse 12, and the host was given him against the daily sacrifice by reason of transgression, and it cast down the truth to the ground, and it practiced and prospered. Okay, now let's go back over this very clearly, because it's important to see what the message is saying here. In verse 11, it says, he magnified himself even to the prince of the host. So he's exalting himself up against Christ, right? And by him, the daily sacrifice was taken away, and the place of his sanctuary was cast down. So who is the person taking away the daily sacrifice? Now, some people have argued that it was Christ that changed the sacrifice. But in the clear reading of the text, that's not what I see. And if you have some other thoughts, please submit your comments and questions. But I don't see, if you're fighting against the prince of the host, and then by him the daily sacrifice is taken away, I don't see how that's confused with being Christ taking away the daily sacrifice. Now, the reason that these other folks suggest that is because, remember when Christ said that the temple would be destroyed, right? And he went into the temple that day, and he crashed down or trampled down the money changer's table, and the money went flying everywhere. And he was speaking or making that was a gesture, right, against the sacrifices. And then it was several within that time. those 70 years when the temple was destroyed, the sacrifice ultimately was ended, right? Because there was no temple. But so there are some people that would argue that it was Christ that ended the sacrifice. But I don't think that's what the text is saying. You do your reading and pray and ask for guidance, but I don't think that's what the text is saying. Nevertheless, we'll go on. The host was given him against the daily sacrifice. And the host was given him against the daily sacrifice by reason of transgression, because of the transgression. What was the transgression? Him trying to magnify himself, exalt himself against Christ and God the Father. And because he became, right, the prince of the earth, we know that Satan has a certain amount of control and rule over the earth, as we can see. Lord have mercy, there sure is enough happening. That certainly is sinful, if not demonic, right? And this is what he's talking about. He took over. He trampled down truth. We've talked about that several times in our Bible study. He's trampled down truth to the ground. I mean, really, these days it's almost impossible, right, to tease out what is truth. It's sometimes impossible to get people to actually say, tell the truth. As they say, tell the truth and shame the devil. Tell the truth. Some people can't do it to save their lives, literally, unfortunately. Truth is almost, it's been almost like thin air, like a vapor. And it practiced and prospered. So this is what we see today. Demonic activity, occult activity, sinful behavior, transgressions, abominations against the Lord, prospering. I mean, if you weren't, if someone just kind of dropped you into the earth today, right, and you spent 24 hours here, I mean, my goodness, what would you go away saying, right? How would it be described? Predominantly, the predominant description would be malice, hate, murder, sinfulness, all that sort of stuff. And then, thank God, every now and then, amen, every now and then, hopefully more for some of us than others, or all of us than others, there's a glimmer of truth and hope and love, protection, honor, integrity, justice. Don't let me get off on that. All right, so let's go on. Verse 13. Then I heard one saint speaking, and another saint said unto the certain saint which spake, how long shall be the vision coming concerning the daily sacrifice and the transgression of desolation? Now, this is the same description that is also referred to as the abomination of desolation. Okay, the same idea here. Transgression, abomination of desolation. Okay, same thing. And this one saint said to the other saint, how long is this daily sacrifice and the transgression of desolation? So how long will the sacrifices be ended? And how long will the abomination, the transgression, carry out? To give both the sanctuary and the host to the trodden under, and the host to be trodden underfoot. So clearly, again, this is why I say it cannot be Christ that is the one that's getting rid of the sacrifice. If you read here again, it says, to give the sanctuary and the host to be trodden. Well, clearly, Christ is not trodden himself, right? He's not trodden the temple. So who's doing the trodden? Who is always trying to fight against Christ? It's the Antichrist. And he said unto me, unto 2,000. And 300 days. There's our first number, Remember, we said we're going to be talking about these numbers, so write this down. 2,000.